WRSR, Owosso, Flint. The following program has been pre-recorded and is paid for by Discover Flint Township. The views expressed are those of Discover Flint Township and do not necessarily reflect the views of 103.9 The Fox or Krill Communications, Inc. Welcome to Discover Flint Township, a program showcasing our local community. Flint Township is ready for your next move. And now, your host, Flint Township Economic Enhancement Director, Tracy Tucker.
Hey, everybody. Welcome to our first show of Discover Flint Township. This is Tracy Tucker. I'm the Flint Township Economic Enhancement Director, and this is Discover Flint Township. We're wide awake this morning, and we hope you are too. This show is sponsored by Flint Township, HAP, Financial Plus Credit Union, and Shea Automotive Group by Stacy Shea Fields. And we wanted to introduce everyone to our community, the events that are going on here. We want to discuss everything that's going on, jobs, new businesses and events. And we'd like to answer some of the questions that our listeners and some of our community have. Today, we are going to introduce you to our primary sponsors, HAP, Financial Plus Credit Union, and Shea Automotive Group. And we're going to start the day off with the health sector, and that's going to be Ms. Bridget Hollingsworth Stafford from HAP. Yes. Hi, good Bridget. Morning. How are you?
Great.
Good.
Thanks for having me. We're so happy to support this project.
It's been wonderful. You guys are great community partners, and we love working with you. This is just one of the many projects that we've done together. You have your community health fair every year. That has been a great success. How has that been affected with COVID? I know you. Why don't you let us know how that's affected you this past year and what's going on this year?
Yes, it has been a challenge this year with COVID. You know, we've had the dual roles, if you will, of helping our members stay healthy and safe, and also finding ways to engage with our members in the community virtually. You know, we've had to transition a lot of the events that would have normally been done in person to virtual events. We've had a lot of the community partners that we support really needing more help than ever with the community members who are struggling. We're finding more food insecurity. We're finding people that need help with just the most basic of needs. So we've pivoted just a little bit and moved towards helping those agencies that are really addressing those social determinants of health and helping our members just get by right now. That's been really kind of our goal. And I feel like we've done a really good job, and we've had great engagement from our members in helping that, you know, to get through this pandemic together.
And I know it's been difficult. What are you guys seeing as the largest concern where your members are at right now? What are they asking? What's one of the biggest questions they have?
A lot of people are afraid to go to their doctor appointment or afraid to, you know, go out into the community. So a big part of what our outreach has been over the last several months is, first of all, reaching out to our most vulnerable members. So we've done some analysis, and so we know based on data about our members that certain members are more at risk for loneliness, they're more at risk for food insecurity, and some are at risk for contracting COVID just because of the community that they live in or what they're doing. So a big part of it has been, again, helping people meet their basic needs, but also making it easier for people to get care. So we have waived all cost sharing for telehealth visits, and a lot of care can be done via these programs where you visit with your physician either on your smartphone or on your tablet or your computer, and also just a plain old-fashioned phone call. So we've encouraged members to continue that care with their provider, to get that preventive care that they need, and to not neglect their other health issues as they're concerned about contracting COVID-19. And now that the vaccine is starting to have a little bit broader use, and we're seeing now the states and the municipalities having plans for how they're intending to roll out vaccines. Our job right now is really helping to address the concerns that that folks naturally have about this vaccine. There is a lot of misinformation. There's a lot of fear, and there's a lot of not me first. You know, people don't want to be guinea pigs.
Right.
But what we're finding really is that these vaccines have been tested extensively. In fact, Henry Ford Health System has done several of the vaccine trials over the last several months. And so we are confident that the appropriate testing has been done, that the acceptable level of getting this vaccine to people. It's a big project that we are just embarking on, and we know a big part of it is communication and helping our members feel comfortable.
Sure. And that is the key, I think. And you know, so we're running a little short on time because we're going to try to fit everybody in on the show. So going forward, we want to see, you know, our members and your members and our community to stay safe, stay healthy. And we want to thank HAP for being a part of this. And if anybody has any questions that they would like to address to HAP or any of our sponsors, we'd like you to reach out to us at, you can email myself, ttucker@flinttownship.org, and just reference the podcast. And we will have HAP back on January
24th. Yes, we'll be back on the 24th.
Great. Any last minute things you want to, we've got about 45 seconds. What? Okay. Any last minute thing you'd like to say?
Well, I want your listeners and our neighbors here in the Flint area to know that HAP is here. We are here to help you. Visit us at HAP.org for information. You can also drop me a line at communityoutreach@HAP.org. And we will address your questions and concerns. And we so look forward to working with you this year, Tracy. We've got a lot of great things to share over time. So we are so excited to be part of this project.
That's great. And we want to remind everybody, shop local, buy local, and discover Flint Township. Well, we want to thank you, Bridget, for being on. And we'll have you back on, like you said, the 24th. What's the website people can find you at?
People can go to HAP.org. It's a great place to start for information on our products. Also, general information about health and wellness that anyone can access. So visit us anytime. We're happy to have you visit.
Great. See you back on the 24th.
Bye.
Bye. Hey, we're here with Kristen Brisbane from Financial Plus Credit Union. How are you today, Kristen?
Good. How are you, Tracy?
I'm great. You know, this is going to be fun doing this podcast throughout the year, Discover Flint Township. And you guys are one of our primary sponsors at Financial Plus Credit Union. And we just want to give you an opportunity to let the community know what you guys do there. So why don't you start us off with what you guys do in the community and what kind of services you guys provide?
Sure. Well, Financial Plus serves over 55,000 members, and we provide a full range of modern and accessible banking products and services to members. And we operate through 8 conveniently located offices in Flint, Swartz Creek, Fenton, Grand Blanc, Howell, Saginaw, and Davison.
Yeah, I want to mention too that I think your corporate offices are based in Flint Township, right?
Yes, our main office is on Vance Lake Road across the street from General Motors.
Yeah, so I think you service all the union members and you do a lot of great things with them. Can you tell us some of the projects you've done with the unions?
Sure. We have partnered with GM and our union partners. We go into the plants and we will open accounts for them. We bring in prizes. We collaborate on their sponsorships with them. They recently were a sponsor of our Pink Night Palooza fundraiser. So we partner with them throughout the year and we love the partnership.
Yeah.
The continued support.
That's great. That's great. You know, I come from a GM family, so it's always good to hear the support that they receive from the community and the businesses here alike. What other services does your company offer or does your credit union offer?
Well, the cool thing is joining Financial Plus is free and easy. So you can just apply online or stop in any branch. But right now for our current members, we have a refer a friend program. So all they have to do, a current member refers a friend or family member to open a Financial Plus checking account or a new loan. And each person receives $50.
Yeah, and so when you're part of a credit union, you're a member, right? You're not just taking your money there and leaving it, right? All right.
Yeah, no, you're a member.
Right.
So that's one of the cool things about a credit union is you're the membership, you're the owner of the credit union, basically.
Yeah, and you guys have been great community partners with the Bristol Road CIA and our Flint Township DDA and Flint Township overall as a whole. So you came on and decided to help us out with this podcast, and you guys will be on your first show is going to be on January 31st. That Sunday, you guys will be the main event that day. But what are some of the things that you'll be talking about this year?
Well, for our podcast segments, we're excited to share knowledge from our Financial Plus experts in our mortgage department, commercial. We're going to discuss credit building and so much more. Just follow us on our Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, LinkedIn, YouTube. We always do educational pieces there if you miss the podcast. And we're also going to share to our social sites as well. And anyone can always visit our website, myfpcu.com, for details.
Perfect. And so they can go to that website to ask questions to be answered on the podcast as well, right?
I believe on Fox's, we're going to have a portion where they can ask questions. And of course, on our social media sites, we can always answer any questions. They can call our contact center or email at info@myfpcu.com.
Great. So we're going to have a spot on Fox 103.9's website where you can ask questions that you would like us to address. And we will have all of our sponsors will answer any questions that you have. We have Financial Plus Credit Union, which we have Kristen here today. We also have Shea Automotive Group and HAP. And they'd already heard from Bridget today, but I want to continue with you, Kristen. How have things affected your members and your employees with everything that's going on with COVID? And what do you look to do in the next year going forward, I guess?
Well, sure. Our core dedication is always our members and the communities we serve. So just going through and trying to help each member what their needs are, keeping our employees safe. One of the things right now, we have appointment only and our drive-through services. So, you know, just keeping everyone top of mind during the pandemic, and always visit our website or social media sites to see any updates. But we truly do care about our community and our members, and we want to keep everyone top of mind. So
great. Yeah, I know we all feel that way. Well, I want to thank Kristen for being here today. She is the public relations and social media specialist at Financial Plus Credit Union. And Kristen, can you give them your website one more time and your Facebook information, please?
Sure. It's myfpcu.com. And then it's also myfpcu on Facebook and Twitter. LinkedIn is Financial Plus, and so is YouTube. So follow us, look for more information, and we look forward to coming on the podcast again.
Great. And we look forward to hearing from you guys again on January 31st. Financial Plus Credit Union will be our focus sponsor. So we look forward to hearing from you again. Thanks, Kristen, for coming in today.
Thank you, Tracy.
Thanks. And now joining us, we have Stacy Fields. She's the lady that puts the she in Shea over at Shea Automotive Group. And she is also one of our primary sponsors that will be joining us throughout the year for the podcast. Their focus show is going to be on January 17th. But for right now, let's say hi to Stacy. How are you today?
Hi, Tracy. I'm great, Tracy. Thank you. Hi, Rusty. How are you today? We're excited to be a whole part of this podcast here with Flint Township.
Yeah, we're excited to have you. You know, so what made you decide to be a part of the podcast?
Well, as you know, we're trying to grow deeply into the community. We've tried to do as many community events as possible this year, and we're just excited to continue to grow within the township and be certain that, you know, we're doing our part in giving back and providing information to those that have automotive questions or involved in fundraisers, anything along those lines.
That's wonderful. And I know last month you guys partnered with Salvation Army to bring back Christmas, and it looked like a great event when I went by. And it's nice that even with all the COVID issues that are going on, that you guys have been able to do some great events, including you did a Trunks and Treats event last year.
Yeah, we kept it going pretty much all year round. We did, the trunk and treats. That was great. In October, we had probably 450 cars through that we gave away candy. We had several different partners in that event, which was great. Salvation Army event just in December was fantastic. I think the Clydesdale horses were actually my favorite part, but the wagon full of toys was fun as well. So everybody came by and donated toys, and they could get their social distancing picture with Santa. That was great, as well as the Clydesdale horses. And we did some specials too at the dealership. If they donated a toy, they got $500 off a car, additional funds for their trade-in. So, you know, we try to tie it all in together. It was a really great event, though. We had a great turnout. It was a little bit of a rainy, cold day, but we made it through, and we collected a lot of toys for those in need.
Yeah, it was a wonderful event. And then going forward, what are you going to bring to the table for people during the podcast? I know we're going to be asking questions of different people. We have, HAP is bringing health information, and Financial Plus Credit Union is bringing financial information. And then we have Shea Automotive Group, and I'm assuming it's going to be automotive related and retail related and community event related. Am I on the right track there?
You're totally on the right track, Tracy. We're going to do part of our segments are going to be educational. So it could be understanding the difference between buying or leasing a vehicle, maybe understanding how the financing of a vehicle works within the dealership. Is it through the manufacturer like General Motors Financial, or do you use your local credit union, and the pros and cons of both? We're going to discuss, all types of different items relative to servicing your vehicle, the sale of a vehicle, and kind of try to walk through the processes and procedures for, we all assume that everyone knows how to buy a car, but that's not always true. And some people only buy a car once every 10 years. Others buy one once every 2 years. So we're going to walk through those, the processes and procedures, and try to make part of our segment educational. I can actually, anybody that wants to email questions in advance for the year, we'll try to touch base on each segment, and I'll provide those emails at the end of this podcast.
Sure.
But
sure.
Anything from understanding automotive insurance. So I'd like to bring in one of our insurance reps, maybe even two, and they can discuss, Michigan no-fault insurance, how the insurance works, how to, make a decision as to what you want your deductible to be, things along those lines. So part of our segment will be educational. The other part of our segment, we'll be talking about any community events that we're doing within the community, upcoming events, upcoming sales events at the dealership, how you can partake if you want to volunteer with us for some of the events that we're doing for the community, things along those lines. And really, like I said, informational and educational all at the same time.
That's great. So along that line, what kind of special things do you got going in January?
Well, in January, we're going to do a large Martin Luther King event. Obviously, that seems like the appropriate timing.
Sure.
We'll do a Martin Luther King sale here at the dealership. And then we have some pretty exciting events coming up for the community relative to Martin Luther King. So I'll be making those announcements on our January 17th segment. And we'll try to focus a little bit on the events as well as what we have going on here at the dealership on a month-by-month basis, kind of announcing what we have coming in the future months. So, for example, in February, we're going to do a Women Empowerment event, and also do a Women Empowerment relative to the automotive industry and who works in the automotive industry, and maybe have some of our She and Shea girls on the radio.
Yeah, that's great. And I know you've been part of the Bringing Rosie to Flint actions that have been going on. So any news on that?
Well, I actually have Mackenzie Miller here who just walked in. So I'm going to have Mackenzie touch base a little bit on what we did with Rosie the Riveter and when we're expecting the unveiling of Rosie the Riveter in the Flint Bishop Airport. Mackenzie?
Hi.
Hey, yes, Mackenzie. So,
hi, everyone.
Hi.
So the Rosie the Riveter Radiothon, it was a huge success. It was so much fun to partner with somebody who was such an inspiration for women everywhere.
Sure.
And to be able to be a part of making history is something so important to Shea and so important to us as women here that we just could not say no. So in January, we are going to be having an unveiling of the Rosie statue that will be at the Flint Bishop Airport. And I don't know if you guys know this, I'm sure you do by now, but that is the first female statue that's going to be put up and built from the automotive industry, including, you know, planes, cars, etc. So
Right. It's
a pretty exciting event, and I cannot wait for that to happen.
Well, as a woman, I say, hey, that's great. And I love Rosie the Riveter. Who doesn't love Rosie the Riveter?
I know, right?
So we'll probably follow up more on that when it gets closer to time for the unveiling of that statue. I'm so proud of all the people that have been involved in this to try to bring Rosie to Flint. My mom worked in the shops back in the 50s. So it has personal importance to me as well. So we're going to wrap up. Go ahead.
No, I was going to say it was pretty exciting. We had two Rosies come in the day of the radiothon, and they had both worked. They were both Rosies, and it was really exciting to meet them and hear their history. And they both made donations to bringing the statue to Flint Bishop Airport. So, you know, we were excited to help Ann Birdland Taylor. I'm not certain if you know exactly who she is. She's with Back to Bricks.
Back to Bricks.
You know, this was really her baby, and with everything that had transpired in 2020 with COVID, we just really needed to jump in and help her. A lot of her events got canceled. So we did it right here on site at Shea Automotive Group in our certified pre-owned building. And we raised quite a bit of money and helped her get her goal to the finish line. So we appreciated that partnership, and we look forward to doing a lot more of those events in 2021.
That's great. Okay. Hey, Cece, we need to get that email address and your website. So if people want to ask some questions, they can find you.
Sure. So our website is www.SheaChevrolet.com. That's www.SheaChevrolet.com. We also have a Buick GMC website, so SheaBuickGMC.com. That's our informational website, inventory, things along those lines. But as far as educational emails that you can send any of your questions to, you can send it to me directly, sfields@SheaSavings.com. So that's SFIELDS@SheaSavings.com. Or you can send them to Mackenzie Miller. Mackenzie is our director of marketing in-house here. So send the questions to Mackenzie as well if you would like. MMiller@SheaSavings.com. That's MMiller@SheaSavings.com. We look forward to receiving your questions, and we'll answer them throughout the podcast in 2021.
Yeah, that's wonderful. But you know what? I think I want to talk a little more about Rosie, especially since we're bringing her to Flint, but we're also bringing her to Bishop International Airport, which is in Flint Township. So we're so proud to be a part of that. Do you guys have any more information on the Rosie the Riveter statue?
We do. Mackenzie, do we know when the actual unveiling in the carousel will be?
I believe it's going to be Monday, January 4th is going to be the unveiling. And where it's going to be at, it's going to be between one of the, I think it's number 3. So the luggage carrier, it's going to be at between number 3 and number 2 is where I believe that's going to be at.
Yeah, Tracy, have you seen the other statues there in Flint Bishop Airport in the baggage claim area?
Yeah, I have. They're wonderful. So, yes, they are. But you know what? They're both guys.
Yep, they're both guys. And so we're excited to see Rosie the Riveter there. I believe from what we understand, the actual statue is going to be on Carousel 3 in the baggage claim area. We've heard of two different dates for the unveiling. We've heard Monday, January 4th, and we've also heard the 11th. So yeah. I believe Amberlynn Taylor from Back to the Bricks is keeping it somewhat of a secret, but I believe it'll be on the news. If we get further information as to the exact date, we're certainly let you know.
Yeah, so it might be tomorrow. That's great. Hey, yeah, and you know, I don't mean to disparage that they're both guys. They are very important guys to our area. There was Mr. Durant, I believe, and is the other one, Louis Chevrolet, I think is the other statue. I would have to look that one up, I think. But yeah, and obviously very big names in the automotive industry and the history of Flint. But sorry, Rosie's my favorite. So, while you put the she in Shay, she puts the she in industry.
Very good.
So, anyway, this is our premier broadcast, our premier podcast, I guess we should say. This is the first one we're doing. We kind of wanted to do a setup of everybody that's involved with it, myself from Flint Township, and then HAP, we had Bridget Hollingsworth Stafford, we had Kristen Brisbane from Financial Plus Credit Union, and Stacy Fields, who is joined by Mackenzie Miller. We were glad to have you, Mackenzie. They're both from Shea Automotive Group. And, you know, we have been so proud of the businesses that have decided to step up and help out with this podcast. And I think this is going to be a great private-public partnership between the township, the township DDA, and these companies, and we look forward to trying to help the community know what's going on, not only with community events, but with the businesses themselves, and maybe answer a few questions that can help them out in their lives as they go along. I'm trying to think of what I would think was interesting if I was listening to a show. And one of the things I normally get asked a lot is, what's new? What's coming? And, or what's going on that site over there? I see a lot of work going on. And I don't know if you, Stacy and Mackenzie, have seen, we've got a lot of building going on in the township. We have a new manufacturing facility that is a supplier for GM Ground Effects on Bristol and Van Slyke.
That's exciting. More development is always exciting in the Flint Township area. Can you disclose, Tracy?
Yeah.
The building there, or is it still confidential?
No, it's Ground Effects. They're getting ready to open in January, so sometime this month. And it's about 400 jobs, so we're very excited about that. And then we've got, you know, everybody knows Culver's opened last year. But we have some new stuff. Everybody's noticed some construction going on next to them. That's McAllister's Deli. Have you guys ever had McAllister's? I've seen them.
I haven't.
You haven't?
I've seen them, but I've never tried them.
Yeah, no. I know. I'm excited. And I know that we have a Jersey Mike's coming sub shop. And we've got Value City went in the Art Van store. We've got the Old Town and Country Bowling Alley. That's being redeveloped. It's so nice to see some of these old buildings being repurposed, you know. I know
it's
that
it's also very nice to see new companies being built, especially how many jobs were lost in 2020 and how many businesses had to close down. So it's really refreshing to see everybody opening up and these jobs being available for people in our community.
Yeah, that's right. And you know what? And it's so good to have you guys here with us, and now they're telling me that I talk too much, so I'm going to have to wrap this up. But going forward, that's the kind of news we're going to try to bring people. So if you have questions about what's going on, I think I have to sign off here from Discover Flint Township, and I want to thank Stacy and Mackenzie for hanging with me for this last couple of minutes here, and we will be back on January 10th on the Discover Flint Township podcast with, it's sponsored by HAP, Shea Automotive Group, and Financial Plus Credit Union. And we'll be back. We'll actually be talking about township affairs at the next one. So, and then we will have Shea Automotive on January 17th, HAP on January 24th, and Financial Plus Credit Union on January 31st. Thanks, everybody, and have a great day. Thank you guys for coming along. Bye.
This has been Discover Flint Township with Tracy Tucker. For more information, visit discoverflinttownship.com. Flint Township is ready for your next move. The preceding program.